and Campisi goes onto the left wing, and Brian Smith, after originally being selected on the right wing, moves to halfback. Steve Tymon comes back from injury at number eight, so Troy Coker goes into lock, and David Cody, a replacement against France, plays on the side of the scrum. Australia's captain for the 19th test time in a test is Andrew Slack. The Welsh have had horrendous injury problems during this World Cup, but the rest have a familiar look about them and could stretch the Australians out wide. In the forward pack, it's a big day for young Richard Webster. He plays his first test match wearing jersey number 7. Steve Sutton, a replacement against the All Blacks, plays his first full match of the Cup. And he's partnered in the second row by the team captain, Richard Moriarty. Supercharged atmosphere here at the International Stadium in Rotorua as we prepare now for this playoff match for Third of England, the referee this afternoon. And away we go here at Rotorua in this match for third and fourth place between Australia and Wales. And the first touch of the ball, Andrew Leeds, the Australian fullback. First line out of the match then, just in Australian territory, just looking at some of these numbers, Simon Poidevin at the back of the line out for Australia, and beside him is the new man Richard Webster, number 7. Alan Phillips to throw, good ball win by Richard Moriarty. Here's Mark Ring, John Devereux, good scything run from left wing three quarter Adrian Hadley, and the Welsh showing an early willingness to move the ball, and a flare up. David Cody and Gareth Roberts, and Cody's the man called out.
David Burnett, the touch judge on this near side, very quick to point out the offence by David Cody, and they are fired up, all right.
So an early opportunity for Wales to hit the front of the match. Paul Thorburn will kick for goal.
And he's kicking into this southerly, which is actually quite chilly. For Rotorua, we're up quite high on the plateau. But this kick is not an easy one, but Thorburn has proven in the past that he can really kick this ball.
Rather surprisingly, in 5 games in this tournament, Thorburn has only kicked 27 points. He's hit it well, just holding up though. This is the Australian halfback Brian Smith, and he's not going to find the line. Taken by halfback Robert Jones. This will come in just on the 22 in Australian territory. Cody has it. Australians trying to set it now, 5 metres out from their own 22, and Fred Howard blows the whistle. Australia has the advantage in this first half of a light southerly. Five metres out from the 22, Michael Liner, his first touch of the ball.
I think it's a problem for Wales how much ball they can get. They've got the backs, as we've said. If they can just get their fair share of ball, I think they can give the Wallabies a bit of hurry up.
Bradford line-out win in the first line-out for Richard Moriarty. This time looking down towards the back, where Wibbs is jumping against Poitevin. Poitevin wins the battle. This is Smith inside the 22. And that's not much of a kick from Brian Smith. The little fellow who was originally selected in this match to play on the right wing, but has come into halfback with Nick Barr-Jones' withdrawal. Alan Phillips to throw to the shortened line-out. Three players on each side in the line-out. The big men are all there. Looking towards Paul Moriarty. Good tap again by Moriarty. Robert Jones takes it in. 15 metres in Welsh territory. Halfback is Richard Moriarty. This is Davis. This will come down inside the 22 and just in the field of play. No score on the game. 4 minutes gone. Wales have done all the attacking in this opening 4 minutes, and it's hooker Alan Phillips to throw. Another good line-out win for the Welsh. Another penalty, and again it looks like David Cody's being called out.
Stomping. He's off. He is off for stomping.
Let's have another look at this and have a look at David Cody. Look at him climbing in that ruck there, number 7. And Fred Howard was right on the spot. And he only had to look at the number, having already warned Cody once. And the second time it was curtains, the early shower for David Cody. And so Australia are going to play this match with 14 men. And away he goes. And we've only had 5 minutes in the game. So what a sensation in this opening 5 minutes as Paul Thorburn lines up his second penalty attempt. Beautifully struck. So Wales at the front after 5 minutes by 3 points to nil.
And it's been all Wales so far, and the sending off of David Cody, depending on the suspension, whether or not it comes into test matches or whether it's just a week's rest from club football, might be interesting.
Michael Lyon will have to start again. Jonathan Davis, and so for the first time in the match the Australians move inside the 22 in Welsh territory. Five-man line-out called by the Australians. It was a bad leap by Cutter. He mistimed it totally, and the Welsh have it. So far they've done everything right in the forward exchanges. There it is for Jones. A little 21-year-old from Swansea, Robert Jones. And he'll be pleased with the way his forwards have performed in this opening 6 or 7 minutes. Wales ahead by 3 points to nil. The Australian backs have it for the first time. 10-metre line of Welsh territory.
Well, this Welsh side is come back from Sunday's game against the All Blacks with a vengeance, and they're climbing into everything. And the Australians, with playing with 14 men, they've got to really lift their game.
Steve Tymon is still packing on the back of the scrum, so there's a flanker missing on this side. David Cody off after 5 minutes, sent from the field by Fred Howard. Well, good shove from the Australians. Remember, they've only got 7 forwards. Here's Liner. This will be awkward for Thorburn. Burke is bearing down. Well taken by Thorburn. The kick from Jones. Oh, that was beautifully worked. But the whistle has gone. Fred Howard has
offside.
I think it was offside.
It was offside. Fred Howard, the referee, played the advantage, and a good playing of the advantage.
So here's Michael Leiner with a fairly easy kick at goal. This one, it's not too far from centre.
They talked about this game being a nothing game for third place between Australia and Wales, but you've got to remember that these sides are playing for their country. And so when it's a test match, they go out there to win.
The last Australian sent off in a rugby match was Paddy Batch against Swansea in 1975. 12 years on, David Cody is dismissed. Well, he doesn't do that very often. A rare miss from Michael Leiner, and it's still 3 points to nil to Wales. Jonathan Davis has taken a quick one. This could open up for the Welsh. Devereux is there. Evans. What a great try. No, come back. Come back.
Forward pass. Forward pass.
Well, all the players coming from the Welsh in this opening 10 minutes. And that looked like it was going to be a sensational try. But this pass from Devereux to Evans is ruled forward. And that's where the movement stopped. Back live now inside the 22, Michael Leiner. And that's a very good kick by Leiner from inside his 22.
Well, that was a hairline decision by Mr. Howard. But of course, if you want to be technical, every pass is forward if you stop and look at it.
That's the 10-meter line in Wales territory, just to the right of this lineout, which will be fed by Alan Phillips. Wales ahead by 3 points to nil. Australia, a man short. Cody is off as Jones kicks. Leeds waits on his own 10-meter line. Robert Jones inside his 22. The Australians continuing to throw two shortened lineouts. Looking for Capper. He hasn't had much luck so far as Steve Cutler, but there's a penalty this time. Some pushing going on in there. And so here's another opportunity for Michael Leiner. Just going back to that sending off of David Cody, in fact, is the first Australian to be sent off in a test match. So he now has that rather dubious honour. He lasted just 5 minutes in this match, and Australia playing the final 75 minutes of the game with just 14 men. That's a much better kick from Michael Leiner, and Australia back on level terms with the Welsh after 13 minutes of play. And there sitting beside Alan Jones is the man who lasted just 5 minutes in this game, David Cody.
Australia really one of those 3 points just to get on the board, because as you say, Grant, they're playing with 14 men, and it's going to tell in the second half, to the last sort of 20 minutes. When they're pushing against eight all the time, they won't be able to get to that loose ball or have that support play for Portman. But the Welsh are a different side today as they were as from Brisbane on Sunday.
Thorburn with the restart. The Welsh have been winning all the ball. A was knocked on though by them as they came through, so it'll be a scrum. Cameron Lillycrap on this side of the Australian scrum. That was knocked on by the Australians. It's the Welsh ball pushing 8-7. Held by Paul Moriarty. Back to Davis. Floating it out. Hacked ahead by Hadley. This is Andrew Leeds inside the 22.
Brian Smith offside. Goes right back, Mr. Howard. He played the advantage, and that's one thing about Fred Howard. He does play the advantage very well. It's up to the individual referee, of course, as to how long he lets the advantage go. He's got, it's a very subjective test. He decided that the bad pass from Jonathan Davis, and it's better to come back and give Wales a kick for goal.
Fred Howard, the 38-year-old from St. Helens, has had a very good World Cup. Many, in fact, were tipping him to be there at the finish and to do the final, but that honour, of course, has gone to Kerry Fitzgerald. But Fred Howard really has created a big impression with his refereeing in this World Cup. Again, just holding up, David Campisi. Not a particularly good kick. Jonathan Davis waiting for it. In fact, it's picked up by Devereaux, almost to halfway. Good ball coming here for Wales. Davis again. Campisi standing outside his 22. Oh, that's a poor kick. David Campisi, he doesn't know whether he's a winger or a fullback these days, but today he's on the left wing. Fifteen minutes gone in the match, it's 3-3. Alan Phillips is the thrower. He didn't play against the All Blacks. Well taken by Paul Moriarty at the back of the line-out for Wales. They continue to win all the ball. Six-two is the line-out count so far to Wales, and they have the put into the scrum. Coming finally for Jones, back to Davis, the drop kick from Davis, never really hit it very well. Now the bounce here could be interesting. It's bounced nicely for Campisi. And the crowd are getting right behind this Welsh side. Skipper Richard Moriarty's won some good line-out ball early on. There's Cameron Lillycrap in the front of the line-out for the Australians. Behind him is Troy Coker. Another one for the Welsh. Davis to ring. Got through the first tackle. Devereaux. And he lost it forward at the crucial moment.
Once again, those forward passes depriving Wales of points. But what a tremendous pass Robert Jones has to get Jonathan Davis outside the cover.
Quickly back from Smith to Liner. Still in play. Adrian Hadley out on the left wing side. Well backed up by Paul Thorburn. One penalty goal so far today, Paul Thorburn, and it's 3-3 in the match as Tom Lawton throws. Wales winning a surfeit of ball here. 8-7 in the pack duel. There it is again for Davis. Again angling it away behind Campisi. Paul Thorburn surveys the options and decides to kick it for touch. He really didn't have much option there. There are only two or three players back in support.
What's amazing me today, Grant, is the number of missed kicks that both sides have done. The ball screwing off the boot. That one from Paul Thorburn was a very ordinary kick, and we saw one from Liner and one from Campisi. It must be very difficult for a player like Campisi, who I think is one of the great wingers of Australian football, and yet now he doesn't know where he is, either at fullback or on the wing. And surely if you're going to make a test career, you've got to make your mind up where you're going to play. And I think that Alan Jones is not really playing fair with David Campisi.
Well, that sums up what the crowd thinks of this match so far. They really have been behind the Welsh. It's 3-3 at the moment, and we have an injury break. The man receiving attention is Steve Sutton, the big number 5 for Wales. The man who's played against the All Blacks, Graham, I think we could probably call enthusiastic.
Or robust, perhaps, I was thinking of. Grant, he came on, as you know, as a replacement, and he was so fired up that he caused a bit of concern to some of the All Blacks with his physical approach to the game.
So this line-out is 10 metres out from the Welsh 22. We've had 18 minutes. And finally, Steve Cutler has grabbed one for the Australians. Whether, in fact, he can work it back to Brian Smith is another thing. There it is now for Liner to Slack. Burke having a run. Good, solid tackling from the Welsh. Still 10 metres out from the 22.
It's interesting, the tactics now, Grant, whether they're going to spin it wide, the Wallabies, without that second flanker.
Here's the drop kick from Liner, and it's away to the right.
Because they have got some speed outside in the centres, they've got a makeshift back line, but because they haven't got that support play with Cody out, they might have to play it closer to the scrums and the set pieces.
Australians now a little wary of Jonathan Davis dropping out from the 22. He fooled them and almost created a sensational try to Evans in the last time he dropped out from the 22. Untidy palming. Webster has to go down on the 22 in Welsh territory. And a little bit of an experience, and Richard Webster has lost it, but here it is for Mark Ring. And now the chase is on. Ring in again. Finally grabbed by Smith for Australia. Wales still have it. Might all come to nothing because the touch judge has his flag extended on the far side. Coming for Wales now, Jones to Davis, Ring. Campisi has called for it. Oh, he took his eye off the ball. And finally the clearance from Peter Grigg. And we're going to have to go right back across the other side of the field.
I think it might have been a Welsh punch on the far side, but we're going to one of these days come to the time when a try is going to be scored and the line umpire will have the touch judge will have his hand out, and it'll be interesting to see what the referee will do in that case.
Guy Moret, the French touch judge, is reporting, or has reported, to Fred Howard, and now the player being called out is Adrian Hadley, the left wing three quarter for Wales. See if we can pick this up. Oh, it looked like an indiscriminate boot there, whether in fact Hadley was going for the ball, and I assume that he was and missed. That was what Guy Moret, the umpire, has signified to Fred Howard, so the penalty to Australia. Once again, Liner has missed touch. And the clearance from halfback Jones for Wales. Just over halfway through the first half. It's 3-3. Another line-out win. This time it was Sutton for Wales, but there was some pushing going on there. The Welsh have a lead in the line-out count of 8-3. Quite obvious the Australians are missing Bill Campbell there in the middle of the line-out.
Yes, they are, Grant. They're also missing David Cody. This is a long kick for Michael Liner, right on halfway. He's got that wind that's actually getting up, and it could actually increase in the second half, which I understand this is what happens in Rotorua, that the wind does get up in the afternoon.
Good kick from Liner. Devereaux has it. And look at the strength of John Devereaux. That's always very dangerous for a defensive team if the ball bounces from the post. But it was well read by John Devereaux. Line out win here for Australia finally. Liner missing out slack to Burke. Not a good kick from Matt Burke. Not a good kick from Thorburn either. Here's Andrew Leeds. Waiting is Jones. We do apologize for the picture disturbances we're having at the moment. 23 minutes gone in the game and it's 3-3 Australia-Wales. Good win that time by Cutler. Again untidy from Smith. This is Poitevin. Just on the Welsh side of halfway.
Jonathan Davis can't believe that Mr. Howard's given the put into Australia.
Once again a good scrum from the Australians, remembering they have 7 against 8, but it's now been spoiled for them. David Cody is off the field, sent off after 5 minutes. Right on halfway. Davis was looking for the blind side, changed his mind, goes back to the open side. Greg has it for Australia. Jones won't. At least it was Davis wanting the late charge. And it's been awarded too by Fred Howard.
I think Davis should put the ball up in the air and chase it, but I think he's going to go for position.
That's a huge punch. Well, that's a magnificent kick.
He made the right decision, I thought, perhaps an up and under in the middle of the paddock, but that's a better kick than the up and under.
We haven't really seen the best of Jonathan Davis in this World Cup. So there's a great opportunity for the Welsh, with Tom Lawton to throw right in his own line. Oh, lovely take that time by Steve Cutler. That was an important line-out win. Back now for Liner. Pressure, 15 minutes to go till halftime. 3-3. Alan Phillips to throw. 20 metres from the Australian line. Webster doing good work in the back of the line out there for the Welsh. Finally handed back by Moriarty. Jones, here's Richard Moriarty. The flanker Gareth Roberts. Wales just a couple of metres out. Yes! Roberts, in fact, the man who took it in, was driven over by the rest of his forwards and the Welsh have the first try. Let's have a look at it. As Jones went the blind side, there was good support here from his captain, Richard Moriarty. Now Roberts has it, and he doesn't let it go. He's driven now by the rest of his forward pack, and down they go. Fred Howell is right there, and Wales have the first try of the game.
This is good work by Richard Moriarty. Watch the way that he comes in support of his halfback when he runs the blind side, and you watch the way he holds the ball in one hand, like Corin Duadua, the Fijian first fighter. Watch this. He hands it out in, and there is Roberts in support. Now watch the way that Tony Buchanan was right behind him, and they just forced him over the line, and Fred Howard right in good position.
There's the man who scored the try, Gareth Roberts, scored a try against England in the quarterfinal, and here he is popping up again against Australia to give the Welsh a lead now of 7 points to 3. Liner with the restart. Clever stuff there from Mark Ring. Ring has actually left the field of play. Now he's re-emerged just down bottom left. You can just see him coming into shot. He ran right out of the field of play. And already we've seen the Welsh fool the Australians with a quick tap up from the 22. Here's Andrew Leeds on halfway. Thorburn waiting. Leeds bearing down on him. Looking at his left winger, Adrian Hadley,
who hasn't got a left foot. He got himself into all sorts of bother there trying to kick with his left foot, so in the end took it out with his right.
This line out on the 22-meter line and Welsh territory. Untidy that time for Robert Jones. One try scored in the match. Gareth Roberts was. The Welsh ahead by 7 points to 3.
9-5-4-1.
Tom Lawton to a full line out this time. Sutton in there. Now a chance for the Australian backs. Again missing out Slack and Campisi on the burst. Just couldn't transfer it to Peter Grigg, and it was knocked on. Well, that was the most explosive piece of play we've seen from the Australian backs so far.
They had all their backs in that move. Campisi was on the extreme outside with a double skip. Campisi coming in. He's quite dynamic.
Welsh on hard defence. Jones with the clearance. Remaining in the first half, 7-3, Wales lead. Good leap by Tyneman that time. Australians starting to work together better as a unit now. Burke. Matt Burke. Fine try by Matt Burke. It came from this line out. It was a good tap by Tyneman. It was well won ball, but look for Matt Burke coming in on the charge. And he hardly had a hand laid on him. He sailed through 4 or 5 tackles, and a very good try for Matt Burke. The man widely tipped to turn to rugby league next season. He had a father who played rugby league for Australia, and he played for Manly, and many are saying that next year this man will play for the Manly Warringah Rugby League Club in Australia.
Yes, he's a very, very good player. Now watch the way they, it was very quick ball given out to Smith. Now watch the way that he comes in, Burke, close to Andrew Slack, and then just chops off his right foot. He wasn't going to pass to anybody. He tucked the ball under his arm, and good individual skills.
Michael Liner just waiting while a Welsh player is attended to. Problems there for Michael Liner, so Australia hit the front now by 9 points to 7.
At the moment, Australia have come back from that early try against them. And if they can get that ball, we said before the game that Wales might have a problem with the amount of ball they were going to actually win.
Well tapped on the Welsh side, awkward for Jones, somehow gets it across to Davis. Across to Devereaux, chased by Burke. This is Evans.
Good play by Leon Evans. He got himself into a bit of trouble, but got out of it very quickly with that little kick ahead.
31-28.
Another good win by Moriarty, but one of the Australians has come through and snaffled the ball. In this Welsh side today than we saw against the All Blacks. Competing very well on the line-out time. In fact, at this stage, the line-out count definitely favouring the Welsh. Bad pass again from Smith. Some of his passing today has not been great. Andrew Leeds hasn't found touch. Thorburn has Evans running with him. Now it could open up a bit here. Yay and Evans. It's tapped into touch by Leeds, the crowd appealing for the late tackle.
But once again, I think they should have held the ball and passed it instead of kicking it into touch. That's twice now that Wales have kicked when they've had men in support and the try was on.
7 minutes to go in this first half. Australia leading by 9-7. Right out in front of the Australian goalpost as Andrew Slack takes it in. Oh, bad mistake by Leeds, but offside against the Welsh. And Fred Howard going across to have a look at Michael Liner. Well, Alan Jones said...
What, the Australian Rugby Union get more money for Concord than at the SCG? But another rumour is that the SCG, the board, have given them a sort of basement price for the game. But the line-out counts now, Grant, are 10-all. And remember before it was about 8-3? So Australia have really come back in that line-out.
This line-out is in the 10-metre line in Welsh territory. 9-7 Australia leads. It wasn't thrown in straight. Australian backs lining deep. Again, Smith is in trouble. Well recovered by Peter Gregg out on the right wing side, though. Well, young Brian Smith, playing in his fifth test match today, is really having a bit of a nightmare. His service to Michael Liner has not been up to international standard. Held in the back by Paul Moriarty. The Welsh have superior shove in there.
Fred Howard said accidental offside as the scrum split. The Welshmen ran into one another.
Once again, Smith's in trouble, but he's managed to extract himself this time and come out of it extremely well. Initially, he was off to pass it to Liner. That way was blocked. Brian Smith, who made his test debut for Australia, in fact, as a first 5-8 against Korea, and that day scored 17 points.
Australia would love to have a try on the board or more points before half-time. 5 minutes to go. They're down inside the 22, so perhaps it's the Welsh ball, though, but if they could just get that try, it could really lift them.
Here's a chance for the Australians as Lawton comes through, but Fred Howard once again has blown the whistle to call a set scrum. sends to Davis, and the Welsh are going to open it up from here. Oh, Ring was in trouble. Davis gave it straight away to Burke, Gampisi and Peter Grigg. Well, that was foolish stuff from the Welsh, and they paid dearly as Peter Grigg gets a try on the left wing side, even though he's the right winger. Watch Davis here, he thinks about it, and the long pass from him to Ring, and Ring went to kick, and it was partially charged down, and it was all trouble from there on in as Burke gave it to Campisi, and looming out wide was Peter Grigg, and Australia has its second try.
And that's the try they wanted. Once again, it shows how you get into trouble by running off your own line. Perhaps a long pass then from Ring if he had the chance, but at the moment, it was in Australia's hands, it was a try, and Peter Grigg got it.
That's his 12th test try, Peter Grigg, today playing in his 25th international. Just made it for Michael Leiter, and it's 15-7, 3 minutes to go till halftime.
It just shows once again that you don't run the ball out from your own goal line unless you've got big overlaps and you're not going to make mistakes. And we've seen it so many times, international players that should know better trying to run it from their own goal line, and the result has been they've given away points, and those points could be crucial for Wales. They've now got an 8-point deficit.
Time running out in the first half, just a couple of minutes to go. Hoidevin tries to control it from Australia. Smith back to Leiner, outside his 22 this time. The Welsh this time pulling the shortened lineouts with Paul Moriarty at the back. Richard Moriarty and Steve Sutton. It's the big number 8 they're looking for, and he gets a free jump this time. Back to Davis, plenty of room on the blind side. Looming up is Hadley. Good strong run from Adrian Hadley. This is the big prop forward Buchanan. Well, the Welsh seem to have the measure of the Australians out wide. That was a strong run from Adrian Hadley, and we've seen good running also from Devro and Yayan Evans. Once again, Smith is in trouble. And of course, one has to remember they're only 7 in that Australian scrum, and so the Welsh certainly have the shove.
They have got an inexperienced forward pack, though, basically.
Davis missing out Ring. Thorburn is in. Lost sight of it. Campisi. Just a minute to go to half time. Australia lead by 15-7. 2-1 in the first half. This line out is 15 metres in Australian territory. Steve Cutler got both hands to it. Liner. Poitevin standing wide. Pushes off Ring and can't hand it back. It's taken away by Webster. He's having a good debut to Sutton. Here's Buchanan again. This is the hooker Phillips. Charge from Moriarty. Was won by the Australians, but look here as number 7 Webster takes it away from Poitevin. Poitevin takes it in and Webster grabs it away and then carries it on. This is the 19-year-old making his test debut, and then it was all on for the Welsh. Buchanan had a run, the hooker Phillips, and looming inside was Paul Moriarty, the number 8 forward, and that's a very good try.
They made it harder for themselves, as if you watch Phillips, it was easier to pass on the outside from this move here. He had a man outside, it was Ring. Instead, he went inside to Moriarty, but Moriarty's got the strength and goes through Liner's tackle, and that's a good try for the Welsh.
Stadium, and Australia leads at halftime by 15 points to 13. National Stadium in Rotorua, the halftime score, Australia by 2 points, 15-13 over Wales, two tries apiece so far in the match, but the Welsh turn in the second half with the advantage of a light southerly breeze.
Yes, and as I was saying before, the whisper in Rotorua is that the wind gets up about this time of the day, and that it will be behind Wales, so they can get down into the Australian half with that added advantage of the wind behind it. Wales, with that one-man advantage, have got Australia on the run, I believe, in this half. But Australia, don't count them out, because they're starting to come back with that more ball in the line-out. And that's, if they can just deprive Wales of the ball in the second half, they could win this game.
Away we go then in the second half, with Australia ahead by 15 points to 13 at halftime. Robert Jones, the halfback for the Welsh, had a very good first half, and he started well in the second half as well.
The lineouts in the first half were 12 to Australia and 11 to Wales. At one stage it was 8-3 to Wales, so you can see how the lineout count has gone ahead now to Australia.
Another lineout win for the Australians. Andrew Slack, Simon Poitevin standing out wide. The Australians regrouping 15 metres out from the 22. Burke across to Campisi. Chasing onto it, David Campisi. Back goes Gareth Roberts for Wales. So it's been a fascinating battle in the lineouts. The Welsh got away to a very good early start, but Australia really have come back well. Slack again, chipping it in nicely behind the Welsh backs. 10 metres out from the 22. Richard Webster went in and grabbed it. It was sitting there, it was loose, and he did the job a loose forward should do. Here's a break from Jones. And a late tackle. Fred Howard has having a word with Michael Liner. And this will be a penalty where the ball landed.
Perhaps a bit of frustration from the Wallabies.
There's the beautiful Springfield golf course in the background as Paul Thorburn lines up a kick that could take the Welsh into the lead. In front, 16 points to 15, 3 minutes gone in the second half.
Good kick from Paul Thorburn, but he's got that win behind him now. But Australia they've really got to lift their game now. They know that all the elements are against them, and they've only got 14 players. They've got to, I think, just play it tighter than they are, get the ball out, and let Lina do a bit more kicking.
Once again, the man taking the ball is Robert Jones. Not finding the line this time. Andrew leads across to Campisi. This is coming down just near the 22. Paul Moriarty, the man who scored the try for Wales just before half-time. Australia at the moment appear to only have 13 players on the field. No sign of Peter Grigg out on the right wing side. Now Smith. This is for Burke to run onto. Matthew Burke, in fact, running wide on the right wing side because Peter Grigg, it would seem, is off the field. So 13 men on the field for Australia at the moment. And offside, the ball came from the halfback, went back. It was the captain, Richard Moriarty, who stepped down from an offside position. And Andrew, at least Michael Lina, to attempt a penalty goal. Kick from Michael Lina could put Australia back in front, down at the moment by 16 points to 15. We're 5 minutes into the second half. It's a seesaw match, this one. So Australia back in front now.
Good pressure kick from Michael Lina there. There's been some very good kicking over this World Cup. There's been some very big kickers, and most of the teams, we look back at Corin Duadua from Fiji, comes immediately to mind, and Paul Thorburn can kick them, and Michael Lina. He really is a fine kicker, and of course, Grant Fox.
Wales taking a quick kick across to the far side. We can tell you that Nick Farr-Jones is on the field for Australia. So he'll no doubt go to halfback. We'll just have to see where Brian Smith finishes up. So there's Nick Farr-Jones, who didn't originally take his place in this team because of injury. But Peter Grigg has left the field. David Cody was sent off, so he's still down to 14 men, Australia. But they lead by 18 points to 16. 10 metres out from the 22 in Australian territory. And offside against Sutton. Grovelling around to the wrong side of the ruck. Driving the Welsh back deep inside their own territory. And there is Nick Farr-Jones. And it'll be interesting to see what impact he has on this match. Brian Smith has had his problems in at halfback, and he is now out on the right wing side where he originally was selected to play. Paul Moriarty back to Jonathan Davis. leads just inside his own territory. Under it is Jones, and Leeds arrives at the same time, and the mark is awarded to Robert Jones. The shadows lengthening here at the international stadium. The Australians will be pleased. They have the sun in their eyes at the moment. Good leap there by Cutler. 12 metres in Welsh territory. Now far Jones to Tom Lawton standing wide. This is Campisi. Just fired it anywhere, and it was finally Richard Moriarty, the big Welsh captain, who ran it across the touchline.
And all credit to Australia in the second half. They have really lifted the game. They're looking like the side we know Australia can be.
Far Jones to line up. This is Matt Burke, one good try already in the match. Having trouble working it back though, and it'll be a scrum. Nine minutes gone in the second half.
I think Far Jones coming on to the field, Grant, will mean that the Wallabies will play it much closer to the forwards, because he loves to run, as Nick Far Jones. And it'll save his forwards from running that far.
Far Jones, oh, it's charged. Well recovered by Steve Tyneman, and point of him was there as well. There it is for Far Jones. Line up for Campisi to run onto. Flicked it nicely in field towards Matt Burke. Ball still loose, very close to the line. The flag is up. Yeah. 10 minutes gone in the second half. Australia with 14 players, leading Wales by 18 points to 16. That's the Welsh goal line, just to the right. Lovely take by Richard Moriarty. Jones waits. Line out 12 metres from the Welsh line. Cutler gets high. And as play carries on, there was a bit of a to-do off the ball. Big Troy Coker against Paul Thorburn. It was relatively harmless, just a bit of pushing and shoving. Far Jones to Liner. Slack, Liner doubling. Burke taken away though by Devereaux. Gareth Roberts, the loose forward, was there. The Welsh should win this one. Jones back to Davis.
Good play by Wales then. Australia getting on top, it seems, in the second half. And the Welshmen need to get back into the Wallaby half. They've got to score a try.
This crowd of close to 30,000 at Rotorua this afternoon are very quiet when Australia are attacking. They get into gear somewhat when the Welsh start to look likely.
Referee looked across to see which half of the field they were in. They're in the Welsh half, so Australia get the ball. The attacking side.
18 points to 16, and just a word here that if the match should in fact be all square after 80 minutes, there'll be no extra time played. Third place in this tournament will be shared. Way to line up. Another well-judged kick by Michael Leiner. Starting to control this match now is Leiner. And I think it's got something to do with the better service he's been getting in the last few minutes from Farr Jones.
Yes, and he's realised that he's got to protect his forwards. He's got to have them keeping down the sidelines. If he's going to have them right across the field, they're going to tire with only seven men.
So this looks like an action replay of the lineup we saw about 3 minutes ago, almost right on the Welsh line. Steve Sutton it was who went high. This is Australian ball. Ordinarily, I think they'd go for the big pushover here, but they've only got seven players. Leiner, drop kick from Michael Leiner. And yes, he's got it again. 21 to 16. Michael Leiner from a very handy position. No problems at all, and Australia now lead by 5 points, 14 minutes gone in the second half.
And deservedly so, because Australia has been playing really good football in the second half, and Leiner saw the opportunity very quickly and let fly.
Andrew leads, dots it down, we'll restart from the 22. Ring waiting just on the Australian side of halfway. Managed to keep it in play. No, he didn't, in fact. Did everything in slow motion there, Mark Ring. Australians calling the tune in the second half. As Farr Jones takes it in, 10-metre line, Australian territory. Point of him doubling in his halfback. And the Welsh raking the ball back with their hands have been penalised by Fred Howard. Well, it's a glorious opportunity here for the Welsh to beat Australia. Last time these two sides met in 1984, that was the Australian Grand Slam Tour. They cleaned Wales up by 28 points to 9. These two sides have played 11 times. This is the 12th. And Wales have won 7 of those. Australia's won 4. Good tack by Sutton. Now an opportunity perhaps to see the Welsh backs in action. This is Ian Evans, Devereaux. Boy, strong is Devereaux. Knocked down by one of the Australians. Good ruck ball. Oh, offside he must be, Matt Burke. Play on, says the referee. Now Ring has a run. Opening up for Mark Ring. Forward pass. Well, the referee played advantage. Matt Burke was a mile offside. And finally, it's the Welsh side who've infringed.
And they have thrown away quite a few scoring chances in this game, the Welsh, with forward passes.
Held in the back by Tyneman. Now Farr Jones to line up. Oh, that's head high. Reflex from Jonathan Davis. And that really clipped Leiner very high and hard.
He got a little nudge from Leiner, and that looked a little bit intentional to me. And Jonathan Davis might be a bit lucky that he didn't join David Cody there. They all talk about reflex tackles, but you can't call that a tackle. And Jonathan Davis on Sunday's form doesn't make many tackles, Grant.
Well, if he's going to play rugby league, and he's strongly rumoured to be playing rugby league, he might have to learn to tackle. Minutes gone in the second half. Michael Liner is restored, but Andrew Leeds takes the kick. points to 16, two tries apiece. But Michael Liner so far, two penalties, a drop goal and two conversions. He's lining up 12 metres in Welsh territory. Davis.
So Alan Jones sitting in the stand. He'll be very pleased with the way Australia have played, minus the chappie sitting on his left, David Cody.
Tom Lawton, 5 metres in Australian territory. Once again, it looks like the Australians have won line-out ball. Pretty tight in there, and it's not going to emerge. And the big cheer comes up from the crowd. They really are willing the Welsh on in this match. They haven't really had much to enthuse over in the last 10 minutes or so. Australia have been calling the tune.
Yes, if you look at the statistics, you can see in the scrums, they're now up to 16-5 in the scrums. Well, this will make it 16-6.
The Welsh really have to use their backs. The backs have looked good. They look to have had the measure of the Australians. This is Ring. Not a good kick straight to Campisi. And now Davis has to chase back. Inside is 22. The little man with the big boot. And look at that one go.
He's a beautifully balanced footballer, is Jonathan Davis.
Talking about him playing rugby league, possibly, in years to come.
Well, he'll have to make a few more tackles than he did on Sunday, I can tell you.
This is 10 metres, or 12 metres, in fact, on Australian territory. Sterling job by these seven Australian forwards. Liner to Burke. Campisi, once again the ball's going a bit high. 12 metres on the Australian side of halfway, and the Welsh going in over the top, preventing the ball being freed. Farr Jones takes a quick one. Tom Lawton, the big hooker, to Burke. No, the touch judge's flag is up. Have to come all the way back. He put it down again.
The referee said play on. As the ball went out and came into the field of play again, and it was overruled, the French touch judge.
Australia speeding the game up a little bit. They've lost this line out to Richard Moriarty. Davis.
That is a marvellous kick from Jonathan Davis. He just lined it up for the corner flag. The big wipers kick just went on and on.
Now the crowd becoming somewhat more animated with 20 minutes to go in this match. It's 21 points to 16 Australia lead. Oh, that's a dangerous tap and a penalty.
Penalty count 11-5 now to the Wallabies, and they've won the scrums now 16-6, and the lineouts it's 20-19.
Come on, Bryson. goalkeeping so far is the difference between these two sides. They've both scored a couple each. That's tries. About 18 minutes remaining in the game. Good catch again by Moriarty. Davis to ring. Devereaux. Oh, that's a great fend. John Devereaux. 10 metres up from the 22. Now it's there for Jones. Davis to ring. Thorburn. And why, oh why, did Paul Thorburn kick it?
Into touch and goal, so it's back to the 22. But John Devereaux is so strong, and he just pushed off two Australians. The second one was Liner, right in the face. No one was going to take him down.
The man who scored the only try against the All Blacks, John Devereaux. Meantime, though, there's an injury to a Welsh player. Liner with a restart from the 22. With 17 minutes left in the match. Waiting for it as Ring. Held it well, not a good pass back towards Paul Moriarty. An even worse pass from Paul Moriarty. Devereaux's the man who's trying to recover it for the Welsh. 12 metres on the Welsh side of halfway. Away to Davis. Bit of a lineup here. Thorburn to Ring. Leeds is outside his 22. Now the Welsh, 5 metres up from the 22. Andrew Leeds got himself into real trouble there. He's looking for the 22, but it was nowhere to be found.
I think that's when you just kick it straight into touch grounds and take the line out, because you get yourself into all sorts of bother if you try and run it out when you've got no support, no wingers back to support you.
Robert Jones waiting, taken by Farr Jones. There it is now for Davis. Waiting as Leeds. No mark given. Head high tackle. Adrian Hadley on the left wing side called for the head high tackle. As Liner takes the quick one to Burke. Running outside the 22. This is Hadley, chased by Liner. Oh, through two tackles. Support now from Gareth Roberts, 10 metre line Australian territory. This is Robert Jones. Back to Ring. Hesitation from Ring to Davis. Richard Moriarty standing out wide. 5 metres in Australian territory. Webster charging away. And the whistle is finally blown.
Well, the crowd are loving this. And there's going to be some tired players at the end of this game.
The scrum in centre field, Australian territory, 12 metres. Jones. Badly judged kick. Wasted by the Welsh. And more breathing space for Australia. The long restart from Campisi. This is Robert Jones, the halfback. Ready, he does have to open it out if he can. Taken by Andrew Slack. Paul Moriarty. And the punch went in there.
The Welsh. refs have got to be careful they don't undo all the good work of getting the penalty awarded to them now. But Mr. Sutton, our friend from Brisbane, and Tom Lawton is going to be called out. And Andrew Slack, no doubt, will be asked over. Because the game is getting a little bit close to going really over the top with the boiling points.
Looking to drive the Welsh back onto attack. <laughs> 12 minutes to go in the game. Australia lead by 21 points to 16. For the Welsh, taken in by Webster. The referee though waiting for advantage to Australia. Mikhail Jones wants to get the ball in quickly. He realises he's only got 7 forwards against 8. Back to Leeds. Thorburn. Matt Burke waits. Back to Liner. Now Thorburn's not at home. It's up to Jonathan Davis chasing back. Oh, that's a bit tough. Davis flattened by Brian Smith.
So the referee gives the penalty where the play next would start, which is a line out, and all penalties are 50 metres in. Here it comes now, and that was, well, it might have been a little bit of Hollywood there, twinkle feet, but the penalty's been given. 21-16 to Australia. That's Brian Smith, 11 minutes left.
Thorburn lines the kick up. Meantime, Steve Blackmore, the big prop forward, is being attended to. Thorburn so far today, 2 penalties and a conversion. To the right as Campisi runs it out. And not finding touch. Now Jones. A long one to Davis. What beautiful feet. Now Jones again. And that's a decisive tackle. Webster carries it on. He's had a good debut match.
I think Webster's been the pick of the forwards for Wales today, backed up by the Moriarty brothers. But Richard Webster's had a tremendous game.
10 minutes to go in the game. It's 21-16 to Australia. Davis again, angling it away from Leeds, and he's done it again.
But now they've got to get this line out. That's what Wales haven't been doing. They've been getting down inside the 22 and then failing to take the line out.
...15 metres out from the Australian line. Once again, Wales have been penalised. Welsh have 8 minutes. Australia has a 5-point lead in the match. Alan Phillips to throw for Wales. Good take by Sutton. 1 nicely for the backs. Davis to Ring. Devereaux got a hand to it. Taken by Campisi. Now Burke to Smith. Thorburn going back. Thought about opening it up and away he goes. Devereaux. Leeds has got a handy bounce. Andrew Leeds, the man who created such a big impression against the All Blacks last year in the third test. But it's up to the Welsh now. They have about 6 or 7 minutes.
The Welsh have decided that.
Tap by Sutton. Davis. This is Webster. 5 metres out from the 22 now in Australian territory. Coming on the Welsh side. To Davis. Intercept from Smith. This is Ian Evans. Needs support though, just out from the 22. Now Davis to Thorburn. Paul Thorburn.
Paul Thorburn deciding that their best option was to go for the corner. But Australia ball once again, so well, the Welsh team have to win this ball at the line-out.
Rodriguez took it from Cutler's tack. Far Jones. Just out from the 22. And offside again against Steve Sutton. He gets caught one out of every two lineouts. McIntyre has it.
Robert Jones can't believe it. The ball came out there, but Mr. Howard gave the scrum to Australia. 4 minutes left. And what a game it's been.
So here's a golden chance for Wales. The scrum on the 20. Davis. Leeds coming in. The Welsh going up after Devereaux got it. Turned it back nicely. Here it is opening up. Big lineup. Ring to Thorburn. Yes. Adrian Hadley it was.
What a kick for Thorburn. What a conversion it'll have to be. Ease the angle, but it's still a long kick.
What a kick from Paul Thorburn.
The game is not over. The crowds are on the field. The referee is saying the game is not over. And he's not going to start the game until everyone's off. Now here, the kick went up and Devereaux took it, but it was Evans with the long pass. And watch the way Thorburn sees the gap there between Smith and Tynemann. And then he gives it out to Hadley and he scores in the corner.
Well, it's turned into something rather like a one-day cricket match as the crowd invades the field. But there's still time to go, not much of it. Michael Leiter is going to have to place kick it off.
And what a World Cup it's been. Like, third place. You wouldn't believe it, would you, Grant?
Fantastic. Sutton coming through. He knocked it on. It'll be a scrum, Australian ball. It's rather too far away for a drop kick.
They've got to set it up in midfield and then try for that loose ball and then the drop kick.
Bar Jones to Liner. Burke, they're all in here. Campisi lost it forward. The Welsh can see it in there. So can the referee. They're prepared to hang on to it and hang on to it for a while. Now Davis.
They've got to run it out.
It's going to go down, I think. No, yes it is. So it has to be a restart from the 22. Time is up on the clock. Richard Moriarty. Just outside the 22 in Australian territory. Liner, another big lineup. Slack, Campisi, Burke. Matt Burke. What a run from Matt Burke. Smith. They're all around. Leeds. Campisi. Slack again. Liner making the thrust.
What an amazing game. The World Cup has come to stay forever with games like that. What a great advertisement for rugby. 21-22.
Well, you'd think it was Cardiff Arms Park. The Welsh have beaten the Australians by 22 points to 21.
Absolute disappointment, obviously.
Sure, yeah. Making me the habit of it, unfortunately.
Andrew, the loss of David Cody early in the game, was that to you the deciding factor or not?
Well, mate, I imagine most of the viewers, unless they're very parochial Welshmen, would have thought we'd have been a fair chance with 15, turns we led to 79 minutes with 14, so we weren't thrilled with it, no.
The play, however, you were having a lot of problems behind the scrum early in that first half, and I noticed the change with Nick Farr-Jones seemed to improve that a little bit.
Well, I don't think it was the halfback's fault. I think losing Codes and a bit of a rearrangement in the scrum, and they had to get that organised, and I think they didn't. Coincidentally, Nick came on at a similar time, I suppose, but I thought Brian was doing a good job early.
Were you always conscious of the fact that Wales would come out today knowing that the pride of Welsh rugby was at stake and so important for them?
Yeah, sure. I mean, they're always that way, but we try to concentrate on our own play and sort of forget about the opposition, and we've got pride in ourselves and what we can do, and so we really try and disregard what the opposition are about.
So essentially, why do you think you were beaten today? Just a better team on the day?
Oh, no, I mean, the facts of the matter are, you've got to say 14 versus 15 is not what the game's about. But Wales took the chances, good luck to them.
Andrew Slack, thank you very much for joining us. And here's the happy captain Richard Moriarty. Richard, I'm sure we're going to get a smile on that face very, very shortly. This must be just about like winning the World Cup for you.
Yes, it was very pleasing, you know, after the game on Sunday, to play Australia and to win. Well, as you say, that's we may not have won the big one, but that to us was the next biggest game.
I think in the sweepstakes that are run around the various departments and shops of New Zealand, many would have said Australia 40-10 or something like that. How did you feel about that feeling going into this match?
Well, you know, it's really on the form, maybe. That might have been sore. But I think I said it on Sunday that we were proud and weren't very happy with the way the game went on Sunday, and we had a point to prove today. And when we heard that you know, people were saying they're going to beat us by 40 points, really, that just added to our incentive to win.
Does that make you feel good that of the four home nations that you now have the position of being third in the world?
Well, you know, it was a tremendous achievement for us to really reach a semi-finals. You know, that was something in itself. But to having beat Australia now in a third, fourth playoff, well, that's something again. You know, it's really is a great honour.
Can we look forward to some nice Welsh singing from now on in the next half hour?
Maybe they're not the next half hour, but I'm sure that the boys will break into song this evening.
Richard, thank you for entertaining this Rotorua crowd today with a marvellous game, and congratulations on being third in the world.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
So there we are at the International Stadium in Rotorua this afternoon. Wales have finished third in the Rugby World Cup, the winners over Australia by 22-20.
Secure third place in the inaugural Rugby World Cup. Norman Wilson, a real boil over, but thoroughly deserved, despite the fact that Australia only had 14 for most of the match.
Oh yes, an unbelievably great rugby occasion. If the World Cup or